दोस्तों स्वागत है आपका सेमीफाइनल्स में। आई एम सो एक्साइटेड दैट वी आर कमिंग हियर एवरी डे एंड एवरी डे आवर टीम इज जस्ट गोइंग अहेड एंड अहेड एंड अहेड। हियर लेट्स थ्रो अ लुक एट द फेस कैम्स ऑफ आवर प्लेयर्स हु इज द हीरो बिहाइंड ऑल ऑफ दिस। श्रीनाथ नारायण इज देयर विदित गुजराती अगेन लुकिंग फ्रेश एज ऑलवेज विद हिज ऐप। वी हैव प्रमोटेड हिज ऐप सो मच सागर शाह।
आई थिंक इट इज लाइक दैट ऐप विल हैव मे बी व्हाट 10 कितना 1 लाख डाउनलोड हो गया कि नहीं
क्या मालूम भाई। लाइक लेट अस इफ यू आर वाचिंग गिव अस आल्सो मनी। देन वी हैव निहाल सरिन ओवर देयर लुकिंग आई फोकस्ड एज ऑलवेज। हरिका जी वी हैव विशी आनंद इज ओवर देयर एंड दिव्या देशमुख इज आल्सो ओवर देयर।
सो लेट्स लुक एट विदित्स गेम शैल वी।
श्योर श्योर
समय ओके। सो विदित हैज प्लेड हिज ओपोनेंट हैज प्लेड द G3 वेरिएशन and instead of going for d5, Vidit has played bishop b4 check. And now knight d2 is not so common. Bishop d2 is the main move, and he's played c5. So this is going to be an interesting battle. Let's go to Vishy Anand's game because we have a very nice, interesting imbalance here. White has a knight on c3. Black has a bishop on e6. So here the question is, which minor piece is better? Is it the knight? Or is it the bishop? Guys, one board where I'm very, very excited is Nihal Sarin playing against Igor Yannick, because here is where Nihal has recovered his pawn, has the double bishops, has a weakness on the d-file, d7 pawn is backward, c5 pawn is hanging, so many things happening.
Totally he plays open bishop position, d6. Totally open position, and all the pieces are active. It will be very interesting to see how he converts this game. I think it will be a beautiful mate or something like that as I visualize.
Oh, Harika has already drawn the game.
Oh, Harika drew. Okay. That's a good result.
Yeah.
This game is exciting.
Oh, Hampe has drawn the game. That's actually good news, right? We were in pressure.
Yeah.
Yes, I mean, in a way, the position at the end was around equal. So, good news for Team India. Two draws on two women board. 1-1.
Divya is giving a heart. Oh, no, look at Divya's game.
Let's go to Divya. She played Queen c4, Rook e8. And now Queen b5. Oh, it's a blunder. Because now e8 is hanging. b2 is hanging. Queen e3 check. Bishop f2. She missed it. Divya is losing. Divya is losing her game. Because now... Oh, she's got beaten.
Beaten on what?
Queen e8. It's a checkmate. Oh my god. India loses the first point. 2-1 to Poland. With it down to 7 seconds. Is he getting checkmated? Oh, Rook g8 is coming in this game. Can Wojtaszek find Rook g8 move? If he cannot find, Vidit is fine. Otherwise, he may be in big trouble because Rook g8, Queen g7 is almost a mate. The king is going to be checkmated. He played it. Oh my god, he's found it. And this is curtains for Indian team because now if f into e6, there is queen and now queen d4. What a game by Wojtaszek. King h3. If he goes now king f5, there is knight g7 check. And Vidit gets checkmated after king g5, queen h4 mate. What a brilliant game. Brilliant game. Queen h4 checkmate. Nihal is getting a mate now on the board. He has played queen d8 and his bishop
queen
and queen.
Queen e7.
It's going to be a mate soon. I think time for Igor Yannick to resign. Three pawns is a bit too much to hold in opposite color bishop end games. And
even a fraction of second he's thinking.
Nihal is just winning and he's won it. One win for India.
Now,
let's go to Vishy's board. Vishy's game here,
it has landed into rook and four pawns,
but this is
pawns,
I think, so winning for black because h3 pawn is a weakness and the black king will just jump in with e5 f4. He might give up one or two pawns and he will win this. So I don't think Vishy can hold this. India may lose 4-2 here. Yeah, rook f2. Look at that pawn which was fixed on h3. That will be the one. You will take that pawn and the h4 pawn will queen. Vishy has resigned. India loses the match 4-2. Who is our guest?
He's the expert that we have called today. Hello.
Yes.
Oh, welcome.
Moment. Let me put something.
How are you, Raja?
Okay, so it's fine. I don't need the. I'm fine. I'm good. And you?
I'm happy that you're here, but sad that India lost the first match. Now it's the second match. These Polish players are very strong, man.
Yes, yes. Of course they're strong, man. I mean, they're in semifinals.
So we need to stay steady on board 1 and 2 because that's
where
the
matches have started. Anand is playing against Judah with the black pieces. You can see them on the board. Raja, do you need the link to spectate the matches? I'll quickly send you.
No, man. I'm a chess player. I found one. I found one. I can see the game.
Okay, brilliant. So let's Christoph Duda versus Vishy. Vishy has played the Nimzo Indian defense and he's played this line, which I think he has good experience with. He played it in the World Championship match with Gelfand as well. And I think Anand is sorted there. I mean, won't be too many issues. Let's see. I mean, it's a theoretical position. If you see Vidit's game, he's either playing the Raghosin or he's playing against the Raghosin. Here, he has the white pieces against the Raghosin.
Oh, but this is the fight of two theoreticians. Now it will be fast played by Gregorz Gajewski because he's he knows the theory quite well. So let's see. He should be quite fast. I mean, I don't know. I want to see it now. But
Bishop
yeah, then bishop d7, then the bishop takes on c3, then there is some rook somewhere to d8, and then takes c3, and then queen e7 goes by black somewhere here.
Let's have a look at the game between Humpy and Monika Sochko. Monika has sacrificed a pawn in the opening. It's a very common way to play in the Catalan. She has castled and Humpy is a pawn up. Well, very interesting. She'll put her bishop on b7 and maybe black is doing not so bad. Moving to Harika's game against Karina Sivka. If you look, I think it was the Trompowski system where Harika took on f6, ef6. And now if you see the position, the d5 pawn is isolated, but black has the bishop pair. Amruta, maybe here it seems that black is doing fine, but if she goes wrong, d5 may become weak.
Yeah, I agree. It's not an easy position for me, to be honest, to understand. So, yeah.
Oh, guys,
King is winning.
Oh, King.
What a comeback. Humpy won, so can we just skip this game forever?
What, Humpy won?
Okay,
nice.
Plus 15, plus 15, put 9. If she doesn't win, I don't know.
But look at the time, look at the time, guys.
Humpy won, yes.
Humpy will do it. Now,
Queen up.
Oh, Queen up.
I mean, this for sure. My grandmother would win this.
Grandmother of Tamur is the Baku champion of 1935.
Plus 15, I think it's easy.
But can we check this game, how his opponent is not making a move down to 1 minute?
Yeah, no, he's getting mad,
that's what. Hey guys, Vidit won. Elegant Riggs, what's going on there? She will win probably. But,
Humpy made it three.
I'm looking at this game already, I just closed it.
Yeah, Vidit is also made in three. What a comeback!
What a comeback by Team India, guys! India,
Humpy
is
inside! Humpy has
won.
2-0
is there. 2-0 is there.
Even Vidit is going for the main. Made in three!
Beautiful!
Wow. Main, Queen at 2, Queen at 7, King of 8, Queen at 8, and Bishop G and Queen at 6 made. Wow,
guys,
what a
guys, play. You know what it reminds me of? Of our yesterday's match against Poland.
Exactly.
I told you this 1 hour ago. I don't know why you are so excited now.
Because we have to be excited, Raja Bao. Come on, be excited.
I'm not even looking at that game already. Done for.
Raja, you had promised us to be excited. Now is the time.
Temur, come on. That's the 2 minutes. Temur, 2 minutes. For the boys. 2 minutes.
Come on. Yes.
Come on, rookie and check. Rookie,
she's going to hold.
One and half for India, 4 and half victory. What a win!
Do not go anywhere, guys. Armageddon is now there. What a semi-finals, guys. You have to agree. What an action-packed semi-finals. Can't get any more thrilling than this. 4-2 and then 4-2 and now it's the Armageddon, guys.
Basically, if it's Hampi versus Monica Sochko, Hampi will have 4 minutes, Monica will have 5 minutes. If Hampi draws or wins, she will be through. If Monica Sochko has to win, if it's a draw, India qualifies. So we need a draw.
I need to make some water, guys. I'm sorry, but this is too much. Yeah? This is only two things I predicted in my life like this is Bitcoin and this match.
Guys, yeah. Meanwhile, you can buy Bitcoin and support Team India. Yeah.
Look at the captain of the Indian team. He knows what pressure Hampi is under. He's stressed. Everybody's stressed, guys. Oh guys, there comes Monica. Monica is coming towards the camera.
Okay, Monica is here. She cannot, she's won one Armageddon. Can she win again? I mean, that would be unbelievable. Oh, game began. D4. Knight F6. C4. Oh, it's G3. Catalan.
Hampi's clutch. She's got this.
Guys, so it means Hampi has a decent position. White is slightly better and White is ahead on time by 1 minute. We need a draw. Win is not required for Black. Draw is enough. Let's hope. D2 is hanging. Oh, come on.
Queen E2 is there. She can even... Queen F4.
Hampi is going for it. Come on, Hampi.
Hampi, wapas aa jao, Queen. Yes.
Nice.
H5 is hanging. Oh, nice. Guys, this is great. This is fantastic. Wow.
She's going to. Okay, yeah.
The time is also almost equal. And come on,
Queen,
Hampi.
That's it. She's very prepared. She's got it.
Queen E2 and wins. Yeah, that's it. This is done.
Come on.
Yes.
Pop it to attack. Yes. Yes.
No mess up is possible.
Either Hampi can decide if she wants to win now or she wants to draw.
Of course she wants to win. This she has
to
win.
Hampi open in the chat, guys.
Whatever you do, I am the chat.
Raja, kya ho gaya Raja bhai? Yes, open it.
Naked 50,000.
Last one. Take C3-4.
Take C3-4. Through to the finals tomorrow against the winner of USA versus Russia. It's going to be madness.
Thanks to Raja, to Adipan, to Anish for being here. You guys, without you, it wouldn't have been so much fun to watch this match.
Yeah, and guys, also, I think it's all changed, yeah, in India's favor once we all joined.
It was only Taimur that
was. Yes, Taimur, yeah.
But thanks, yeah.